So in this vlog, let's try to see the implementation of useRef. So in our previous tutorial, we have seen the differences between useState and useRef. And now let's try to practically observe the difference with the help of an example over here. So the first thing is, like, you need to add Flutter hooks as a dependency here in your pub spec file. So as we are dealing with Flutter hooks tutorial, I have already added Flutter hooks. So make sure you add this particular dependency before getting started. So now let's try to import material.dart and quickly try to make a skeleton of our application. So these are all the general things which we have covered in almost all the apps. So I'm just going a bit quick. So now, let's try to create a stateless widget, my app here, and also reformat the code. So now, let's try to return a material app. And inside which, within the home, let's specify scaffold and app bar. And here, let's specify the title with the help of a text widget. So I'm just going to specify useRef. So this is what we are dealing with in this particular tutorial. And within the body, I'm just trying to create one more class called home. And now let's try to create one more stateless widget, which is home. And now let's try to extend it with the help of hook widget instead of a stateless widget. So this is the easiest way of creating a hook widget. So I'm just following it. And now returning a container over here. So instead of a container, I would like to return a column so that we will be having multiple widgets inside it. So the first thing is, like, text form field, which I require over here so that we can input some information, so that we can provide some input to demonstrate the useState and useRef differences. So here we will be considering a controller. So let's try to create a controller over here. So final controller, I'm just making it like controller text. So now, instead of text editing controller, I will be using use text editing controller. Yes, you have guessed it right. It's a part of hooks again. And I'm just going to provide initial data, which is empty I'm providing here. So you can just provide initial data depending upon your requirement. So I have just provided empty for now, as this is a tutorial. So now let's try to specify our controller here. So controller text, and also let's try to add some decoration here. So I'm going to specify constant input decoration so that we can add some hint over here with the help of the input decoration. So I will be specifying enter a name as a hint. This is it for the text form field. You can add additional fields if required. And also now we need to specify a text widget so that we can display the data here. Let's try to create a variable. Let's try to create useState first. So let's try to create name useState here. So let's try to create name using useState here, and initial data again I am going to specify empty here. So now let's try to make use of this and try to observe what a useState can do. So before going any further, so let's try to specify a final object name with useState here. So the initial value is again empty over here. So make sure you are specifying useState within the build here. So if you specify outside this, it will provide you with a warning. So now let's try to make use of this. With the help of a use effect, I am going to demonstrate you the difference here between useState and useRef. So here you can also specify the key values by making which you can rerun this particular use effect block here. So by default it will be running only once on the build here. So controller text dot add listener, so that we are going to observe the input provided by the user and we are going to update our screen, that is re-render our screen and display the data which the user enters. Okay, so now consider name dot, this is of a type value notifier, so we need to specify value while assigning the value and also while retrieving the value here. So here controller dot controller text dot text here, so we are trying to extract the text from our text form field here with the help of a controller. Also let's try to print it so that we can observe the change between useState, and also let's try to print name here so that we can observe the difference between useState and useRef. Name dot value, and now after the text form field, let's try to specify a size box with a height of 20 so that there will be some distance in between two widgets here. So as we are making use of a column, I am considering height here. If you are specifying row, then you can just specify weight, and also you can just make it a constant again. So here with the help of a text widget, we are now going to display name dot value. So yes, now let's try to run this particular code and see the output once. So yes, we have got this error like hooks should be called within the build method of a widget. So I have just specified, right? And even this text editing controller should also be inside the build method here. So now let's try to save the code and check back the output again. So yes, here we have got our text form field, like enter a name here. So let's try to specify the name here, and you can see we are able to find the output below itself. So as you are typing, you are just able to see the output even here. So here you can see we can also find the log here as we type data into our text form field here. We are even able to find the changes in our log here. Let's try to make use of useRef here. So final name, I'm just trying to clone the same line again, and we are going to comment it so that we'll be making use of useRef here instead of useState. So now let's try to see the usage of useRef here. As we have placed cursor on the text form field, you could see the log like name and nothing is displayed after that, so it's empty there. So now let's try to provide a name here. So you can see as and how you specify every word here, you are able to observe the things, you are able to observe the user input, but it is not being rendering onto the screen. So if you go through our previous tutorial there, I have clearly shown you the differences. With the help of a useRef here, you are able to capture the data, but you will not be re-rendering it onto the screen. So with the help of a useState, we were able to re-render the data onto the screen, but which is not in the case of useRef here. And also useRef is used to withstand the state whenever there are any multiple re-renders here. This is all the basic difference which I would like to show you in terms of useState and useRef. So if you are having any queries regarding this implementation, or if you want to know more about useRef usage, do let me know in the comment section below. And the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And for more interesting tutorials, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.